Good afternoon. This is the weekly wrap-up for our previous short week leading into Gold Day and parent and student conferences. I've done these videos for about 2 years now, and we've had some good success with them, but this will be the first time that I'm requiring them to be shown in classes during the school day across the campus. The reason I do that is because we have 2,317 students, which is more than any other school in the city of Louisville, 250 staff members. We want to make sure that we're on the same page, so you get to look at my bald head at least once a week now. I'll apologize for that in advance. I do want to start this week by talking about involvement. One of the things that I've said consistently here and will continue to say is we think that you will be more successful if you are involved in something, be it a sport, activity, club, something. So we've added like 50, 60 different things over the past couple of years. We're adding another one. This is a Black Student Union, which we have at a lot of different high schools here in Louisville. We're adding one here to discuss issues pertinent to our African-American students. The student that will be heading that up is Gary Jones Jr., so find him in the hallway if you're interested in that, and he'll give you more information. In that same theme, I want to talk about the resources we have on campus to support you, the student. We have 4 mental health counselors and 7 school counselors. This is more than any other school, and we have significantly more mental health counselors on campus so that you can utilize those things to talk to them to help you be a better student and prepare for your next step. So please take care of that. Ms. Brewer and our other folks. I want to give a shout out to our deeper learning students that were at the Taste of Deeper Learning this past Wednesday. It was an awesome event. I enjoyed it. Ate a lot of food. It was good. And it's a precursor to November 1st, where we want hundreds of students, tons of students there showcasing their work at our open house and deeper learning exhibition. That's November 1st. Your teachers will be talking about it. But we want, I mean, in a perfect world, if we had 2,000 kids showing off their things that night, like it would be educational nirvana, and we would all be super excited and happy. I want to take a moment and talk about MAP testing. We're done with the first round on the middle and high school side. I want to make sure that you, the student, know what we use MAP testing for. It is a very important test for you to take. You take it 3 times in the year. If you are 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, or an 11th grader, seniors don't. We use that to determine interventions, meaning if you need help in reading or math, we use that data to determine that and then give you more specific stuff that you can do so that you can read better and do math better, be a better mathematician. And for high school students, this is extremely important, and we use this in the scheduling process. So if you go into the test and you're like, I'm not doing this, whatever, you're not going to get the classes that you want. And then you're going to cry about it and be salty about it. And we're going to look back and say, you didn't try. We don't have an accurate representation of what you can do. So that's what you're going to do now because you didn't give any effort. So give your best effort on that because we need to know where you're at in reading and math so that we can do something about it. I want to give a shout out to our sports team, volleyball, both middle and high school. Thank you, ladies. Excellent job this year. Soccer, I want to give a shout out to them. Got the opportunity to see the tail end of the ladies' soccer senior night the other night, and it's really cool. Our girls' soccer team really this year has done an awesome job. I can't stress to you all the amount of positive feedback we get from other schools and parents of students at other schools in the city when they play us, just saying how awesome our team is and how nice our young ladies are and really how much of a family atmosphere they have. And that really warms my heart to hear that. So that's a credit to you all. Also want to shout out football. We are 7-1. That's the second best start we've ever had here at Moore in the history of the school. And we are poised. We can get through John Harden in the next couple of weeks, we will make a deep run into the playoffs. And, you know, I think the sky's the limit with the young men there. So awesome stuff. Now, what I want to end with this week is behind me, this big collection of stuff on my wall. If you've ever been in my office, I was looking at it today and I was like, man, I'm going to try to impart a little bit of wisdom to some of our students about that. That wall for me is my brag wall, like my feel good wall. That's notes from students, from staff, from community members, that every time I get mad or I get like down or I'm frustrated with some expectation that's put on me or something's not going right. And I'm like, man, you know, I'm so angry at whatever it is. I look at that wall and it helps me to refocus and reflect on what I'm here for. I'm here to educate you all. I'm here to run the best school in the city of Louisville and really the best school in the state of Kentucky. So I would encourage you as students, whatever that is for you, if it's a wall in your house, maybe it's pictures on your phone, maybe it's just a mental image in your mind, when you get down, when you feel like oh man, everything's going wrong. Reflect back on the things that aren't, because I guarantee you can find some good in what's going on in your life, even if it's small. And you build on that small, and then it becomes bigger and bigger and bigger, and then it becomes exponential. And then you're like, man, you know, even on my worst day, there's some good stuff that's going on. So I think you guys should take an opportunity and think about that and reflect on what is good and what's going on, and use that to push you forward to your goals. As ever, I remain the proud principal of the campus here. If you haven't heard it from me directly, love being the principal here. Love having the opportunity to lead this school and all the excellent progress that we've made. And now you know more.